Hey, I'm Angie.
And I'm Ryan.
And we are
Happy Healthy Vegan!
Guess where we are, you guys?
We're back at my favorite place in the world, camping on the backside of Catalina, just off the coast of Southern California, here for like a spiritual recharge.
You can't just feel the weather?
No, I mean the prediction. Not the current weather.
Catalina Island. Getting excited.
Beautiful two harbors. Yeah, we have a good time.
We just got off the boat from the main island.
Got our propane purchase, and we're ready to ride over to our destination, Little Harbor.
I don't know if I'm ever quite ready for that bumpy ride,
but I know.
It's crazy.
But it'll be worth it when we get there.
It will. Back in your little home away from home, ready to set up the tent and all that.
Yeah, it's this weird thing, like, we've never left.
Do it again.
Perfect.
I know, huh? The weather is amazing.
Yes, amazing weather.
So good.
And barely anyone's here, really.
Yeah, there's just some backpackers back there.
Yeah, and those bros are gonna hike in.
Yeah.
What's really cool about here is, like, even the nearest campsite, there's someone there. They're like hundreds of feet away.
Yeah.
We've set everything up to perfection. Yeah. Everything is so tidy this trip, too.
Yeah.
We've got it wired.
I know. I think we've got our systems down. And this is the best it's going to look. So we're going to give you a little tour. Let's take a look.
All right.
Oh, wait. By the way, look. Shirt's already off.
Of course.
We've got our tent set up right here with an awesome view. We've got our little, what we call the refrigerator, where we keep our food and beverages in shade.
We got two tables, and look how tidy everything is.
Oh, I love it. So this is the water we brought from home that's already filtered.
And this is our water purifier. We like squeeze it, there's a filter in here, so clean up some of the gunk.
Yeah.
Here's our cooking setup, our Coleman gas stove, and we love this thing. Dual burner, so we can do some great cooking.
Yes, as you guys have seen, if you've seen our other camping videos, all our cookware all fits into this thing. We forgot our board last year. We remembered it this time. We got a little towel. We got Jasmine's bag here in case we need it. Over here, oh, look, technology.
Solar lights, solar chargers.
Yeah, two solar chargers this year. We're not messing around. All right, so it's been a year since we've been here, even a little over a year. So we've been wondering, will the jizz wizard still be in the bathrooms? We'll find out.
All right. High tech number one.
Oh, it's still there.
They tried to cross him out.
Oh, look, the one is like super faint. Yeah, but this one, someone tried to cross him out. Interesting. All right, so as promised, here's a tour of our food here. It's a little crazy. See, we got a bag of potatoes, some corn tortillas, and we got a lot of ripe fruit. I think the blood oranges will probably make it till tomorrow, but this mango is so ripe, I'm concerned. We've got a number of apples for oatmeal. I've got two really ripe cherimoyas we're probably going to eat tonight. I've got some limes. I've got one really ripe peach. I've got some extremely ripe plantains that I'm going to actually make for lunch today. Raisins for our breakfast. Some dried mangoes for the lean times. Dried mushrooms, tomato paste. Now here's something special. I want to try these Trader Joe's vegan marshmallows, which I think are new and they're seasonal. So of course I had to do the whole deal. I finally found a s'more without honey. It's also gluten-free, which is just incidental. Some dark chocolate. These are Brazil nuts that Ryan wanted to bring with us. Of course, oats and rice, which I actually need to give this to Ryan so he can start rinsing it. What else we got? We've got pink lentils, black beans, which we're gonna have with lunch, cannelli beans. What else? Almond milk for our oatmeal. We had this farro last year, so I'll do that again. I've got some cocoa. These are all of the spices, and I've got some jaggery for sweetening. Okay, this is pretty naughty, but actually, Sweet Symbol Vegan told me about this pour over coffee in the bag. She said Conscious Chris had tried it, so I brought some to try. And oh, and then I've got my homemade cookies down here. Yes. So, lots of great stuff, really. I'm pretty excited to eat. Ryan's got some water boiling on the Coleman. He's already rinsed the rice. And it's funny, our cup actually doubles as a measuring cup. It's pretty cool. We'll be reusing this again to warm up some black beans. And I'll be using a little chili powder to spice it up. I've got some lime. And I'm gonna just lightly heat up these plantains. And what else do we got? Oh, and I've got some corn tortillas. So this is gonna be a really festive meal and we are super amped. This is a really beautiful plantain. It's all pink inside. It looks like a Thai banana. Check it out. I've got these ones all prepped over here. I actually put a little cinnamon and chili on them.
Here's the beans.
All right, thank you. They are so ripe. It's like we don't have to cook them, but since I can, I will. The rice has still got to go quite a bit.
Yeah, maybe at least another 5 minutes.
It's heating up torts.
Here's the beans.
All right, thank you. Plantains, rice and beans. It's gonna be a feast. And here is our completed masterpiece. Yeah, bite of approval, dude.
Oh yes.
Getting it done?
Mm-hmm.
All right, cool. Let's go eat in privacy. And here is the view from our dining room.
Not bad.
No. Look at this guy, he's so hungry.
I'm starving.
Here we go. Dissipating, the sun is coming out,
and it's so beautiful.
And sunlight's rays dreams of delight.
Oh, hello there.
Hey.
So this is the Trans Catalina Trail, which you've run some of this, haven't
you?
Yeah,
most of it. Yeah, it's really hilly in some parts. Yeah, a lot of elevation gain. But yeah, it takes us not only to, we're not going to Two Harbors right now, but it takes us to our sunset spot.
Yeah. And it's changed over the years. It used to go like straight up, but now it's like zigzagging. What do they call it? Switchback?
Switchback, yeah.
So, here we go. Wow, this looks beautiful.
It's like... The
oh my gosh, I think it is. Yeah, that's totally it.
Like, no, don't go here.
Yeah, oh my gosh, things have changed. So this is like kind of a back path, goes along the water.
Yeah, back to the beach.
Massive. Someone stepped in. Yeah, boy, that means they're around here somewhere.
Oh, I see one.
Where? Holy crap!
We can get closer. Let's get closer.
Where is he? Oh, there he is. You guys, we've never seen a bison up here at our sunset spot. He seems to be on the other side of the divide, so, you know, we shouldn't be bothering each other. Huge. Gives you a little bit better idea how large these are.
You know your city's dirt and grime just confuses my mind. Doesn't look so pretty, but I don't care. I'm gonna move on and find some air. Right now I can feel the sting on my neck. The burdens don't make it feel so free, but you bring it on home to me.
Chirimoya, but I'm like, cookies, cookies, cookies. But seriously, Jasmine, Sweet Simple Vegan, knows how good these are. I was just talking to her about it the other day. I was like, I'm sorry, I feel so stingy. I only gave you 3 cookies on your birthday. Like, I should have given you like a dozen. It outside, cloudy tonight. That's what I love about it so much. Everything I ever need is in you. Everything I'll ever want, everything I'll ever need is in you. You are my love today, my life tomorrow. Wow. My
Wow. What do you think, babe?
It's pretty dark right now, but it doesn't look like it.
No, I know. It's cold, windy.
Dark really super fast.
Can you see these?
Yes,
I can. Yeah.
Hey.
It's a little cold, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a little cold, but it's
fun. Yeah, your rechargeable lights.
Yeah.
All set up.
More solar lights.
Good morning. So it is a cool morning, overcast, and so I'm going to treat myself to a little coffee. Ryan doesn't approve a coffee.
I approve of pineapple juice though.
Exactly.
And I approve of big ass mango.
Yeah, so we're going to see if this mango is any good.
This is the smallest of the big mangoes we brought.
Yeah, what should I do with
this? Okay, so you find, Robbie yeah. was telling the girls about how, okay, you find the stem. And then you go along the sides of it.
Oh.
Yeah, that should be it.
The stem? Like,
yeah.
You should go off the side a little bit, probably.
And then, yeah, just kind of find the seed and try to carve along the side while it's soft, I can tell. So the last few times we came here, we brought three of these things, but this time they've got like some kind of a weight limit, and we were nervous we were gonna be over the weight limit, and they were gonna try to charge us. So, oh, that looks actually really delicious.
I'm gonna try a little bit here.
Yeah. Looks perfect. Yeah?
Yes, we got mangoes.
I've been asking to make a video about coffee lately. I don't really know what to say. I mean, it's... It's not the best, but I also don't think it's the worst. Let's see if she can do it. Oh, I already smell it. Drug addict.
Right. Brought to you by Trader Joe's.
I know. No, we bought it.
The eye bags are strong. Oh, all right, so let's see here. La 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 la. This is crazy. Oh my goodness. Especially since Ryan's not a coffee drinker, I don't normally have this luxury here. You know, it's coffee.
Drugs. Mangoes.
It's not like the local roast that I'm used to in Long Beach, but it'll do.
Let's hope Darren Ryder didn't see this video.
I was just wondering if Evan Rock's farm has one of these Victorian hand crank pineapple juicers.
Gonna get ready for a little run.
Oh, is your arm beyond?
Yeah.
Tip-line.
Got a GPS it on Strava.
Oh, that's cool. We may not have cellular connectivity, but we still got GPS. So people should be able to look at the Strava of your run?
Yeah, Yeah, totes.
I'm glad I brought my cozy socks. I can be cozy in the tent while you're running like a freak.
All right, cutie. See you in a little bit. Hour or so. I don't know. Hour okay. and a half. I don't know. All
right, man. Have a good one.
All right, see ya.
Bye.
So I just jogged 3.5 miles up, I don't know, maybe 900 to 1,000 feet of elevation getting through these mountains here. Anyway, I'm gonna jog down something I've never done before. I'm gonna enter this canyon, Bin Weston Canyon. It goes down to a beautiful, secluded beach that very few people ever get to see. So I plan to show it to you and head back home. Here I am, guys, Bin Weston Beach. Beautiful, lovely beach. Nice little place to chill out for the day too. All to myself. Nice.
Hey guys, so I could not finish that coffee, to be honest, and I just kept thinking about how good the cocoa was last year, so I'm whipping up some cocoa instead. So good. I'm thinking about walking up to Father Jack's now. Fruits, but I don't know if I'm adventurous enough to try to pick these. I was just thinking about you, our friend.
Oh my God.
Yeah, I just noticed him when I was doing yoga and I was like, wait a minute.
That's him.
That's totally him.
I saw two more back there.
You did?
They're kind of on ridges though. I couldn't like get right up on them.
This guy was actually even lower. He was way down here at the bend.
I was kind of worried what would ever happen if he was like blocking our path.
Yeah, well, good thing he didn't go that way.
Yeah, is he on the switchback? He might be.
Yeah, he's on the switchback. He was lower on the switchback. He was almost down to camp.
Wow.
I have even more exciting news.
What?
Okay, so I was way over there. I was doing yoga and I noticed the tantanka. So I started hustling over to make sure it was. I just saw a dark shape. So I was hustling
yeah.
to see if it was
That's
him.
I saw them too.
Yeah, I was like, that dark shape is huge. It can't be human. So I was hustling over and then I don't know. Somehow out of the corner of my eye, I saw some motion. There was a fox just chilling right in the path.
Oh my God.
It was right in the path. And then when I got up to where it had been, there was some pee and poo. So he was like, just go on the bathroom.
Did you film him?
I tried to, and like...
They're elusive, huh?
Yeah, I tried to zoom in real quick, and then when I looked back at my footage, like, I had filmed the moments after seeing the fox, and not the moments seeing the fox. I'm so bummed.
They're hard to get.
He looked a little scruffy, but he had, like, the really
was
red
he really
chest.
Cute? He looked like a little doggy.
He looked like, ooh, you know, like he was caught. His tail looked scruffy. But yeah, it was the most exciting... I had the most exciting experience.
Great, awesome.
So someone's pretty hungry.
Huh? Yeah, I ran over 8 miles up and down these crazy mountains here. Longest run I've ever done here before, too.
Oh, was it really?
Yeah. Cool. It was gone like almost an hour 45. Yeah, so I'm hungry.
I thought you were back a little early. So I was like, oh, I have a whole hour to mess around and
back,
hike.
I wanted to get back before noon, and it's 11:58. Now I got back
Dang,
maybe 15
you did get
minutes
home
ago.
Early. Home.
That's what I said on the video too. I said, I'm going home now.
Oh, I'm glad you took some video.
Yeah, I had to, since you know, how often do I make it to Ben Weston, right? I didn't shoot a
You might go to Ben Weston.
I didn't shoot a plethora, but I just wanted to get some documentation.
Alright, cool.
Yeah.
Alright, so now we're gonna make you some festive oatmeal.
Oh my god.
And I got the apples I'm gonna chop up, and oh, we'll have to get the sweetener out. Which is crazy. I got all these yellow jackets earlier. All right, so we've got about 3 cups of water. And
maybe 4. I put in a lot. I didn't measure it all.
Okay, and then we have 3 apples and some cinnamon, which already smells really delicious. And let's see. We put like a cup and a half.
Yeah, something like that.
A cup and a half. Should we go? Oh my gosh, that means the quails are going to be going to town on the oats.
Maybe.
I swear, half of the recipes are invented in this camping spot.
Wow.
Yeah.
Place of inspiration.
It really is. Some jaggery powder, which is evaporated cane juice, no pesticides. Direct from farm to kitchen. It's all certified organic. And I'm not even going to measure. I'm just going to.
Here it goes.
The lion's share.
The lion's share.
Did a big run and I already snacked. Yeah.
Does that look like a lion's share?
Yes, it does. Oh my god. Carbs on carbs and sugar.
I know, huh?
Sugar.
High carb vegans, baby.
Yeah.
All right.
Here.
Is this enough for you?
That's way too much.
All right, let me put more in mine then.
I'm like full, so.
All right, you can just scoop some more in mine.
Oh my god. You made an insane amount, dude. You went cray cray.
The hornet is interesting.
He loves it. Got to cook the raisins in there.
It'll still be good.
A spot to have breakfast, huh?
I know, show them our view, huh?
Well, it's starting to look a lot better than I came earlier. Blue's coming out. Let's see, Brandon, Father Jack. Look at Jack. It was something right here, too. Oh my gosh. Jack's. So I'm gonna make Ryan some cocoa, and I was just reflecting. This is another cool reason. Being vegan when you're camping is you don't have to worry about all your animal products going bad without refrigeration. You excited for the cocoa?
Yeah, it's tasting good so far.
I'm in love with the cocoa. Oh yeah, look at that cocoa. I'm gonna be all chocolate, coffee, yeah, give me some s'mores. Chocolate elixir. Who's here? Someone's here. All our friends back. Did I smell some delicious maple? Maybe this is time for Instagram.
Delightful. Yeah, I'm enjoying the sun. Warming up two ways.
Yeah. And then you'll get really cold in that cold water shower. Alright, this is our snazzy outdoor shower.
Yeah, it's not like hot 80 degrees last year.
Oh. dinner, and this recipe is actually in the Keep It Carb Baby book, but it was originally created here. So I've got my ingredients: fresh potatoes, some tomato paste, pink lentils, basmati rice, curry powder, and dried mushrooms. Ryan's been quite the little chef at camp here. I'm impressed.
I know how to cook for camping.
We got the basmati rice going, potatoes are going. I'm over here trying to hydrate my mushrooms. Potatoes are done and they're all bright yellow with curry. We've got some lentils and mushrooms and curry over here.
Rice has been done for a while now.
After burning last night's rice, Ryan decided to put more water and cook like less time. Mm-hmm. What do you think? Is it still moist?
It's getting less moist.
Okay.
Perfect. That'll be perfect when we complete it all. Feels good.
It's been cloudy and cold all day, actually. Here's our completed dinner. And this is our view. Not too freaking shabby. Oh, and the sun came out for us.
Yeah.
Aw.
How perfect. Yeah. Perfect dinner here. Look at this. Totally. It doesn't get better.
Sign of approval?
Right.
Mm-hmm.
I think all our viewers could eat this.
Oh my gosh, there's all these like light effects going on.
Mmm. Hell yeah. Carbs on carbs, baby.
Yeah. Mm. Look how soft the potato. Soft. Mmm.
So good.
Ryan's butt's so cute. Woo. Yeah.
No sticky.
No sticky. They're all red on red. Hi, babe.
Hey.
Looks really pretty right now. Uh-oh. Cat came out of like that hedge area. Ran past this bizarre buffalo patty on the rock.
And acted there.
Yeah, and then up into those bushes. And then I came around where like he's in this little area, and we looked at each other. And then he was like, no.
Sometimes I feel like a motherless child.
Touch of your hands.
Hey, babe.
What?
How do you rate that sunset?
The sunset? It was interesting. It was nice, though. Yeah, it wasn't like yesterday's or it was
nothing
all long.
Like
it's more subtly subdued, beautiful.
Yeah, it was interesting. It was kind of
steep. It's really moody. It's crazy. Even right now, like, you know, if they call last light half an hour after, it's still quite moody.
That is. Okay, don't laugh, you guys, but we actually have firewood here, but we do not like fires, so we cooked our s'mores over this crazy thing.
Over our stove,
a knife.
Yeah, it's working out.
You like it, Ben?
Yeah, it's delicious.
I know, I wasn't sure if he'd be into it. So yeah, so vegan everything, and they're really good.
All right, here we go.
Woo. Brian's bad as approval.
Mm-hmm.
It looks like it's midnight. It's like, what is it, 8:30?
8:30. I just walked back in the dark here, all with our flashlight from the bathrooms, and just like about to go in our tent, we saw like something fall off our table. Like, oh, it's the wind knocking some off. But then it kept running, so it must have been, I saw it's a little animal. I couldn't tell if it was a fox or a rabbit. It's
or
crazy.
The cat I saw earlier?
Or it could have been the cat. Who knows? But a small little animal.
Oh my god. I wonder
on our
we'll
table.
Come back now.
It's
what
like,
was it
he was right around where our Coleman cooker was, so I don't know.
You're like, I want some gluten free crackers.
Maybe so.
Or was it the chupacabra?
It could have been. It's out there.
It's out there. Oh my god, wait. What's up? It's a cat. I think I've figured out where the cats are staying. Yeah. Oh yeah. That's definitely them.
So I'm guessing this colony of cats eat the quails, which seem to be in abundance here.
Hello. I love how they run. So dirty.
So hard.
Bills are getting paid, and all of them on time. Every day the sun keeps rising up into the sky. But every night there's a cold, cold stone where my heart should be. It's put away and locked up. Thrown away the key. Oh, but it's hard, yeah, it's so hard to say what I mean.
Not sure if you can hear me on the middle of my run here. It's so beautiful doing runs here. And there's a bison. If you see a little dot of a speck down there, he's just chilling, the same one that we've been seeing every night up here on our sunset. But we continue on this beautiful, gorgeous run along the cliffs of the coast here. So rad. I'm gonna go. I've been running straight uphill for almost 1¾ miles. I'm still really tired from yesterday's run. I'm quite hungry too. So I'm gonna head back down and have a big festive oatmeal breakfast. So looking forward to it. So hungry, guys.
Back from yoga.
Eating breakfast.
I know, that's great. Right, so, what happened?
I saw a buffalo up there on my run.
He was up there again?
He's on that ridge. You saw him on the first day, just further in, you know, further on down,
oh,
further back.
Oh, wow.
So he's up there on that ocean ridge.
Well, that's funny. When I was doing my yoga, then I looked up and there was a buffalo across from me over there on the road, too.
I'm surrounded by buffalo here. Well, this is it. It's our last day, our last morning here. Just had some breakfast.
Yeah.
Sun's starting to come out. And,
yeah, finally.
We're just going to like chill out for a couple hours and the guy's going to pick us up at 3. Take us back to
man.
Two Harbors, yeah.
When I woke up this morning, it was really cold and super windy. I was like, I'm ready to go. But now that it's a little warmer,
nice,
and I've had
huh?
my yoga and everything, it's like, I want to stay.
We're going to have a nice final 3 hours or so here, huh?
All right, cool. Well, you know, Ryan made me some oatmeal. Yum.
Yeah. Learned it from Keep It Carbed, baby.
Oh, yeah.
So this is the switchback that we walk up to go to our sunset spot. I want to document it. See their horns this time. Two times zoom. Five times zoom. Rats at a count of three. Oh, yeah, there's maybe one behind him. That one is huge, babe. They're huge beasts. I think it started to go back up. That's definitely a male. Probably a good thing those kids are over at the other beach. Okay, there's our camp. And here's the buffalo. one went. Thing is, we need to go right over there to wait for our bus at 3.
Bye-bye, magical little harbor. We love you.
Aw, we'll miss it.
I know. Until next year. Outside my wheelhouse. Running up a mountain, yeah.
That's already pretty crazy. Adventure, huh, babe?
Yeah, good thing we didn't start sleeping.
I know, I wanted to go to sleep.
But I didn't think we'd go to Avalon quite so soon. I was thinking February. So I hope you guys liked our third or so Catalina travel vlog. We love coming here and we love sharing our trip here with you.
I guess fourth counting
the
our flashback Friday. Yeah. Aw, can I have a kiss?
Yeah. Mm. We had a great time.
Such a great time.
Mm. Well, thanks, guys.
All right. So what, they leave their comments down below?
Comment down below. Do you like to see these travel vlogs? Have you ever been to Catalina? Have you, So give us some more camping ideas, because we just discussed we want to camp more around California than just
remote,
here.
Like not too hard to get to, but remote.
Yeah, we don't want to be around a big group of party people. And a like if you got some out of this video, and subscribe for more vegan content of all kind for me and Angie here at Happy Healthy Vegans.
And so until next time,
I just did.
Keep it carved, baby.
Keep it carved.